गुड मॉर्निंग, आई एम के दुबे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, कलकुट्टा यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द वेपर कंप्रेशन रेफ्रिजरेशन सिस्टम। सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द थर्मोडायनेमिक्स ऑफ द कूलिंग सिस्टम, कंसेप्ट ऑफ द कूलिंग सिस्टम, यूनिट ऑफ रेफ्रिजरेशन एंड द बेसिक फंडामेंटल ऑफ द रेफ्रिजरेशन। सो नाउ इन दिस सेशन आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द वेपर कंप्रेशन रेफ्रिजरेशन सिस्टम, इट्स वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल, फंडामेंटल पार्ट्स एंड इट्स थर्मोडायनेमिक। द लर्निंग आउटकम ऑफ दिस सेशन, our students will be able to learn about the VCRS fundamental, actual VCR system, what is the difference between the ideal and actual refrigeration system, the thermodynamics of VCRS and application of VCRS in terms of domestic application, industrial application. So these are the learning outcome of this session. The major highlights of this session: the concept of ideal and actual refrigeration, then energy equation of the refrigeration system with the all fundamental parts, and the refrigeration application for domestic purpose, industrial purpose, ice making, low cooling applications. So these are the major highlights of this session. Now in this schematic, the property chart in terms of the pressure and enthalpy chart is available. So here we can see the pressure condition of the condenser side and the evaporator side and the compressor refrigerant condition and the pressure of the compressor side and the expansion valve side, because these parts are the fundamental parts of the VCR system. So the pressure condition is very important for the refrigerant, because ultimately our objective is to achieve the cooling effect, to efficient performance. I mean the coefficient of performance should be high for the refrigeration system. So through this pH chart we can understand and we can maintain the pressure of the refrigerant, because the different refrigerants have the different thermal property. So according to the pressure limit, means how much pressure is required in the condenser side, how much pressure is to maintain in the evaporator side. So according to the thermal property of the refrigerant, we need to study about the pH chart. So here pressure and enthalpy. So why enthalpy is important? Because the enthalpy is the energy carried through the refrigerant. So we must know about the what enthalpy of the refrigerant in the compression side, in the evaporation side, during the expansion valve process. So through this pH diagram we can estimate the pressure and its energy of the refrigerant during the VCRS system, VCRS cycle, and its working. In domestic refrigerator, the working refrigerant is R134a. So the higher pressure means after the compressor, because the compressor converts into the higher pressure and high temperature. So the high pressure of the VCRS cycle is maintained after the compressor. So according to the thermal property of the R134a, which is used nowadays in air conditioning system and domestic refrigerator system, so the higher pressure is maintained about 7 to 8 bar. And is this condition the refrigerant R134a achieve the superheated condition. So And the evaporator pressure, should be as much as low, because we need to maintain the large pressure gap between the condenser pressure, I mean higher pressure, and the low pressure means evaporator pressure. So it's about 0.01 bar, 0.02 bar. Practically, we are maintaining the low pressure at the evaporator side. So through this diagram, we can set the balance of system for the any cooling machine, any refrigeration machine, air conditioning machine. So this is the very important for the design purpose. So here the VCRS components are available. So basically four components are the fundamental component of the VCRS system. Here the evaporator. The evaporator is actually the cooling space where refrigerant receive the heat from the cooling space and maintain the low temperature as compared to the surrounding inside the evaporator. And as per the refrigeration definition, the refrigeration means to maintain the low temperature as compared to the surrounding. So how low temperature is maintained? So when the heat is received by the flowing refrigerant inside the evaporator, so temperature will decreases. So here the evaporator is the cooling space. And why we call the evaporator? Because when the heat is received by the chilled refrigerant, it convert into the vapor, and then after the evaporator, it passing through the condenser. So the next fundamental part is the compressor. So reciprocating compressor, centrifugal compressor are used in a domestic purpose. Basically, the reciprocating compressor are actually used in the domestic refrigerator. Here, the compressor thermodynamically compressor is isentropic process. It follows the isentropic process. So here, the compressor convert the refrigerant in higher temperature and higher pressure. So the superheated vapor is actually required after the compression. So the pressure is very important to maintain inside the which provided by the compressor. So it's very important, and it's depend on the thermodynamic property of the refrigerant. So the compressor is actually provide the higher pressure, and it's depend on the compression ratio, means the pressure before the compression and pressure after the compression. So the pressure is provided by the compressor, and it's depend on the compression ratio of the used compressor. So the another important parameter is compression ratio of the used compressor. After the compression, the higher pressure, high temperature refrigerant here, after the compressor, the higher pressure and higher temperature refrigerant achieve as per the thermal requirement of the refrigerant. So it passing through the condenser. Here the heat rejection of the cycle is possible. So during the condenser process, it's again works in the pressure, constant pressure, because whatever pressure is maintained after the compressor, the same pressure is maintained inside the compressor. There is no any pressure reduction, because we need to supply the higher pressure of the refrigerant before the expansion valve process. So here there is no any pressure loss, only temperature is decreases. And how it is possible temperature decreases? Because after the after the compressor, here the temperature is about 60 degree C to 80 degree C as per the thermal property of the refrigerant. So and outside temperature of the condenser is atmospheric temperature about 25 degree C. So here the 60 to 80 degree C of the refrigerant is entering into the condenser. So the heat transfer from the 60-80 degree temperature to 25 degree C temperature. So heat transfer is possible. So here the heat rejection from the refrigerant is performed, and the refrigerant is slowly converted into the liquid stage. So here in our video we have seen the two phase and the red line and the blue line. So actually it's showing the phase of the refrigerant. So after the compressor, here the vapor refrigerant is flowing and up to the inlet of the expansion valve. After the expansion process, here the liquid refrigerant is actually flowing and from the outlet valve of the expansion valve and up to the inlet of the compressor. So here the liquid refrigerant is flowing, and as per the thermal property of the refrigerant, the liquid stage of the refrigerant is the very chilled condition, very chilled temperature, is about the minus degree temperature. So after the condenser, the heat rejection is possible. Pressure, there is no pressure loss. The higher pressure refrigerant is entering into the expansion valve. Here the process is isenthalpic. There is no change in the enthalpy. That means there is no pressure reduction. And here the in the compressor, the process is isentropic. There is no entropy change. And the condenser process is constant pressure process, and the evaporator is constant pressure at the low temperature, and the condenser is the constant pressure at the higher temperature. So after the expansion valve, the refrigerant phase is liquid phase, and here the temperature is minus degree temperature. And here, when the minus degree temperature, the refrigerant is entering into the evaporator, here the temperature is atmospheric temperature, say 25 degree, 24 degree. Now the heat transfer from 25 to minus degree temperature. So we can say the heat added to the refrigerant or heat achieved by the refrigerant to maintain the low temperature, because the 25 degrees of temperature is transferring to the minus degree temperature, obviously the temperature will decrease inside of the evaporator. So this is the cooling space. This is the cooling space of the refrigerator. So here the two heat transfer process is actually performed. One is the heat added to the refrigerant in the evaporator, and the liquid refrigerant convert into the slowly vapor phase. That's why we call the evaporator, means evaporation of the refrigerant. And here the low pressure refrigerant and the low temperature vapor refrigerant passing into the condenser. Here again the higher pressure temperature is maintained. So the two heat transfer process is actually performed. One is heat added to the refrigerant in evaporation, and other is heat reject from the refrigerant through the condenser process. So here the four fundamental parts are available: the evaporator, compressor. So here we can say the evaporator and the condenser process is actually constant pressure process, and the compressor is isentropic process, and the expansion valve is isenthalpy thermodynamically performed. So the process is already discussed. The process 4-2-1, the liquid refrigerant is passing through the evaporator, and the heat achievement is possible. Cooling achievement is possible. Then process 1-2-2. Here the higher pressure, high temperature is maintained through the compressor. Then the process 2-3 is the condenser heat rejection from the refrigerant. And then process 3-4 is the expansion of the liquid refrigerant and convert into the low temperature. For the design of VCR system and its analysis, some important thermodynamic assumptions are required. So thermodynamically, all integrated parts should be the control volume and follow the steady state condition. That means there is no energy loss from the system, and there is no any energy change inside the system. So this condition is very important for the analysis and the VCRS design. Second, the die compression is important for the compression process, because if the wet vapor is entering into the compressor, so the materialistic loss will occur. So here we cannot allow the wet vapor inside the compression for the compression process. So the dry compression is important. Then the compressor operate adiabatically, that means we know that the compressor follow the isentropic thermodynamic process, so there should be no the heat interaction from the surrounding to the compressor and from the compressor to the surrounding. There is no any heat interaction, that means there should be no any heat leakage from the compressor, so it should be adiabatically. Then the throttling process. So expansion valve is actually follow the throttling process, that means the very thin coil tube is available in the refrigerator. So here the liquid refrigerant passing through this thin tube or the coil shaped tube, and here the temperature is reduced and convert into the extremely low temperature refrigerant. So the throttling process is important for the expansion process of the VCRS system. So these thermodynamic assumptions are important. Then the kinetic energy or potential energy changes can be neglected, because there is no any because here the important is the cooling effect or the heat transfer, so we can cancel out the kinetic energy effect and the potential energy effect of the system. Now the energy equations for different parts or the component of the VCRS system. So here the evaporator. So the heat interaction in the evaporator, and the evaporator gives the cooling effect. So we can see the energy equation in form of the change in enthalpy. So here, as per the thermodynamic property chart, through this chart, this is TS chart here, and so this is the compression condenser process, here the expansion process, and here the evaporation process, and suppose that the process 1 to 2 is compression, then 2 to 3 is heat rejection from the condenser, then 3 to 4 is the expansion device, expansion of the refrigerant, then 4 to 1 is Q cooling or refrigeration effect. So here we can see the enthalpy change across the evaporation process is the H, because this is the dry compression, this is the vapor line, so obviously the enthalpy at state 1 is more than at enthalpy state 4. So here the enthalpy change is H1 minus H4, and this enthalpy change gives the cooling effect. We can write here Q cooling or Q refrigeration effect. So H1 minus H4, and we can and we follow the refrigerant table, the vapor table of the refrigerant, so we can find out the all enthalpies value as per the temperature and the pressure available in the our practices question. So this equation will give the refrigeration effect. So here the Q is referred as the refrigerant capacity, and the expressed in terms of the kilowatt in the SI unit, and the British thermal unit per hour in the MK system. So the compressor, the process one to two So at state 2, the refrigerant convert into the superheated state. So obviously that state 2 enthalpy is more than at state 1 enthalpy. So here the H2 minus H1, this enthalpy difference will give the compression work. So here we can write the compression work is H2 minus H1. For the condenser, because the condenser is operates 2 to 3, it is the constant pressure process. So here at state 2 and state 3, here this is the liquid line, this is the steam domed actually. So this follow the liquid line, here the vapor line. So enthalpy of the liquid line is less as the enthalpy of the vapor state. So here H2 minus H3, this expression will give the Q condenser or the Q rejection from the cycle. And the expansion valve, because this is the constant enthalpy process, there is no change in enthalpy. So here there is no inequalities follow, only here that we just achieve the low temperature of the refrigerant. So here, because this is the constant enthalpy process, so there is no any energy equation, only we can achieve the thermal effect of the refrigerant. So here the H4 is equals to H3, here H4 is equals to H3. So if we see the pH chart of the refrigerant, so it looks like this. So here stage 3 and 4, so S3 is equals to H4. Now the performance of the VCRS system. So the performance is just similar to the efficiency, and in last session I have discussed the efficiency and the performance, COP coefficient performance, both are same in terms of output by the input. So efficiency only possible for the positive machines, means the machine which give the work output, but the COP is actually estimated and accounted for the machine which consume the energy in terms of the electrical energy, in terms of the mechanical energy. So the COP here for the refrigerator, the COP is defined as the performance of the refrigerator. So the output by the input, we can write output by the input, and output means the refrigeration effect or the cooling effect, and the input is compression work. So as per the enthalpy equation or the energy equation, we have seen the refrigeration effect is H1 minus H4. This is the Q refrigeration, and here this is the work compression. So this is the H1 minus H4 divided by the H2 minus H1. This is the COP in terms of the enthalpy equation. For if we follow the temperature, so because the cycle is if we see this is the low temperature or cooling temperature, and here the temperature, high temperature. So the this VCRS system actually works between the two temperature limit, high temperature and low temperature, according to the thermal property of the refrigerant. So in terms of the temperature, the COP also can be estimated by the T low or the T cooling divided by the TH minus T low. And actually this equation comes from the Carnot refrigeration cycle. We have discussed in our the previous lecture, okay, how this equation is comes, because the COP is minus QH minus QL. This is the COP of the Carnot refrigerator. So because we know that the Q is the function of the temperature, So at the low cooling or the cooling, the heat transfer during the cooling effect, the temperature across this energy transfer is TL, means low temperature, or we can say the cool temperature, or we can write cooling temperature. And energy transfer or the heat transfer through the condenser or the high temperature bodies is QS. So similarly, we can write TH. So this equation comes from this energy transfer equation of the COP. So the both equation is valid for the COP of the refrigerant and the performance of the VCRS system. So the different refrigerant system actually used for the domestic purpose, commercial purpose, the cascading. Cascading means the stages of the refrigeration system. Here 2-stage, 3-stage we can use, and generally cascading is used for the extremely low temperature application, and it is called the cryogenics stage, means the solidification of gases, solidification of CO2, solidification of the H2. So in this system, the cascading is actually used. So here the multiple stage of the compression is working. Single compressor actually consumes more work. Why we are going for the cascading of the refrigeration system? First, we need to achieve the low cooling, and also we need to reduce the compression work. So the single work, single compressor unable to keep the higher compression ratio. That's why we are going for the multiple stages of the compression, and we can achieve the more pressure and more temperature. So it's because we need to maintain the higher pressure and higher temperature of the refrigerant at the condenser side. So here the multiple stages of the compressor is working. So here the compressor 1, low compressor, higher compressor, then according to the our cooling level, we can go for the multiple stages of the compression for the cooling effect. Here the heat exchanging between the condenser and the evaporator. So we can say here the first VCRS, and here we can say VCRS2. Both VCRS system follow the same thermodynamic process, but the pressure level are different. So here we can see the heat rejection from the condenser is heat received by the evaporator of the first VCRS. So here also we are maintaining the heat transfer, means the waste heat from the condenser is utilized, is used by the heat received by the evaporator. So here we are also using the heat from the heat interaction between the condenser and the evaporator, and also we are using the different stage of compression. So here we can see the first stage of compressor is performed by the 1-2 process, and the another compression is performed by the 5-6 process. So here we can achieve the more pressure. So for the single compressor it is not possible. So that's why the multi-stage of the compression is the very useful for the higher pressure and temperature requirement. Then the same thing, the multi-stages of the compression through this TS plot, we can see the compression work 1, then the another compressor here. So the disadvantage of this system, the costing of the refrigeration system, because the two compressors have the higher cost and they consume the more work. But ultimately our achievement is what? Our achievement is the cooling effect. So here we can see this is the actually cooling effect. So we are achieving the more cooling effect by using this staging of the compressor. So for the low temperature requirement, we follow the cascading or the multi-stages of the compression refrigeration system. Then here the multi-purpose VCRS system. Generally it is used for here the condenser, the heat rejected from the condenser is utilized for that as a dry air actually in any kitchen and or for the drying purpose, because the here the temperature is about 50 to 60 degree C. So that temperature we can use as a dry air. Now from the expansion valve here, this is the cooling space, and the another expansion valve is attached here. So the first expansion, here the temperature is the minus degree temperature. Now the cooling effect we can achieve in this refrigerator or the evaporator. Now the vapor refrigerant again passing through the expansion valve 2. So here again we can generate the low temperature of the refrigerant and use as a, we can use here freezer for the ice making and all the things. So here by using the two stage of the expansion or the throttling process, so we are achieving here the two stage of the cooling effect. One is the evaporator cooling effect and another the freezer cooling effect. So the multi-purpose VCR system also applicable and used in the industrial purpose. Then the refrigerant here, there are different refrigerant are actually CFC type refrigerant, SCFC type refrigerant. So the at present time we are using HCFC refrigerant is R134a, because the different refrigerant has a different thermal property and its toxic emission environmental effect. So the selection of the refrigerant actually depend on the its cooling value and its environmental ozone depletion value and global warming potential, we can say the ODP and GWP. The refrigerant, suppose that if any refrigerant have the zero value of ODP and zero value of the GWP, that means it is the eco-friendly refrigerant. So nowadays we are using R134a. So the value of the ODP and GWP of the R134 is much low as compared to the other refrigerants. That's why we have the eco-friendly refrigerant as our R134a in nowadays in the domestically and the industrial purpose. But here the other refrigerant is available R1234Y. It is actually HFO refrigerants. And the HFO is nothing but it is the blends of the HFC and the natural refrigerant. Natural refrigerant means carbon dioxide, water. So the HFO is the another category of the refrigerant, which is the very useful, the very eco-friendly refrigerant, and in a future it can replace the R134a. So this is the actually the R&D is going on this refrigerant. So R134a is nowadays the most eco-friendly refrigerant, but the HFO R1234YF is the future refrigerant, is in R&D level and it can replace the R134a, because the R234 is achieved the zero value of the ODP and zero value of the GWP. So actually HFO is the blending and the mixture of the natural refrigerant and the HFC. Here in this table we can see the environmental property of the refrigerants. Here we can see the all natural refrigerants have the zero value and the minimum value of the GWP. This is the very important actually global warming potential value. So this is the very important for the selection of the refrigerant for the domestic and the industrial purpose. So some practices question we have for this session. Discuss about the VCR system and its components. They explain the complete thermodynamic process of the VCR cycle, means the process of the compression, process of the condenser, expansion valve process, then the evaporation process, then what isentropic compression, isenthalpic expansion process. So the compressor and the throttling valve is the perfectly isentropic isenthalpic process. Now the COP of the VCRS, means the performance of VCRS thermodynamically, we have seen in terms of the enthalpy equation, in terms of the temperature equation. And the question is to briefly discuss about the selection criteria of the refrigerant. Here the most important is the environmental criteria then toxicity and its flammability. These three points are very important for the selection of the refrigerant. Thank you for this session.